Hi, Carrie here from My Cloud Bookkeeping. Today we're going to have a look at how to use delayed credits and delayed charges. So it's a feature that's available in the QuickBooks Online Essentials and Plus plans. If you'd like to see the features for each plan, there is a link below that you can click and get a breakdown of everything. Delayed credits and delayed charges are referred to as non-posting transactions. So what that means is that you have them sitting in your books waiting to post them. So they don't actually impact your records until you use them. You might wonder how that's useful. Perhaps, for example, you have a monthly charge that you want to add to a client invoice, but it's not something that you want to actually post yet. You just want to have it pop up and be aware of it. That's one of the great uses. I'll walk through the example in a minute, and you'll see how I use credits to record any upfront deposits paid. So let's go do a couple of examples, and you'll see how delayed credits and delayed charges could work in your business. Let's start with a delayed charge. We'll pop up here to New. And grab a delayed charge. And let's create this one for Bills Windsurf. So let's say that on a monthly basis, we go in and we do some tree and shrub trimming for Bill, and there are 10 at $35. So we have a delayed charge here for $350, but we don't want to invoice him yet. We're just going to wait and save this for when we do come to invoice him. So now let's have a look and see what happens when we go to create an invoice for Bill. So now let's create an invoice for Bill. So we'll go in here, enter Bill, and look at this. It pops up on the right-hand side as a great reminder. Now we may not want to charge him right now. We might want to send him a different invoice for something completely different, but we do have this option to add it right now, and here we go. As you can see, the description that we put on our delayed charge is right here, and we can send him off our invoice, and we haven't forgotten about it, which is fantastic. So I'm just going to save and close. Now let's create a delayed credit. This is something that I use quite often. If I am working with a new client, I always take a deposit upfront, but I want to make sure I don't forget that I've taken that deposit when it comes time to send them their invoice for their time. So let's see that I've been working with Cool Cars. And I've taken a deposit from Cool Cars for $150. And for the sake of the exercise, we'll have no tax. So let's save and close. Now let's create an invoice for Cool Cars. Pop in here, select Cool Cars. And along the right side here, oh look, we have some different things here. We've got some billable time, some more billable time, and a credit. So let's add all of these, and you can see here that some of the work that we did that was billable, and I have a video on that if you want to check, less this deposit was paid in advance. So by creating the delayed credit, when it came time to bill Cool Cars, we didn't forget about it. We didn't have a separate Excel spreadsheet. We didn't have a piece of paper lying around somewhere. It just popped up so that we didn't forget about it. It's a wonderful time saver and a really great tool. We save it. The invoice is done.
This is another great time-saving feature. It helps to ensure you don't miss out on charging items or upset customers if you forget a deposit. Also, it prevents you having to maintain separate manual records off to the side. It's better if everything's in the same place. You're less likely to make a mistake or miss something. So check out the blog post where I walk through all of the different features of all of the different plans. Be sure to click like, subscribe, and then you'll know when the next video comes out. Hopefully I'll see you then. Cheers.